Well, traders, ZM at new high. JBHT moved to a new low, and I'm done trading for the day. As you can see, I'm up over almost 8,000. In fact, with my open trade, just over 8,000, getting close to the $9,000. So I'm having another green day today. I'm going to finish this week with four green days, one losing day. And I believe I'm over like $40,000 for the week. So that's a good trading week. Not one of my best, but definitely a very good trading week. So I'm very happy with this to finish. And anyway, to finish the week in green note is always fine, always nice. Like always, there are some things we need to talk about, some educational ideas that we need to discuss today regarding what happened today. You may notice something kind of strange in when I posted my pre-market picks. I had Boeing on both sides. I had it on the long side and I had it on the short side, which is quite rare. I don't usually do that. But if you did notice it, I mentioned that it was not a mistake. I wrote it down in my pre-market picks that I was looking for a long and a short in Boeing. We had both opportunities. However, I only used one. In fact, I used the short side only. And my first one was not a very successful one because I was hoping it's going to immediately, as from the open, come down. Then I expected it to go long, that I will go long. And then I expected it to move under the low. So I had, in fact, I was planning up to three trades in Boeing today. I didn't get that. You know, the upside move was too quick for me, which took out my initial short trade. I did promise you one thing, that Boeing is going to be under the lows. And you know, it may sound crazy to you when the stock is moving up, starting with a gap up like this and then moving over the highs, you know, started at 171 and moved over 173. And you look at Boeing and you ask, what is this crazy person talking about that Boeing's going to move under the lows? And I was quite sure about it. That's why I shorted it once more here. And my second trade was very nice. Although you've seen in my result, I just got over my losing trade, my first one. So Boeing turned out to be a small winner. Could have been my best trade today because I was really planning this trade. And if you ask yourself, why did I plan Boeing short? Well, and you probably do ask yourself that. The reason is quite simple. You know, Boeing had some good news today. Pre-market news. If you look at the pre-market news, you find that Boeing was granted an approval for its old story with the 737 MAX version. It was approved by the, I believe, the European authorities today, something like that. So Boeing gapped up today. And if I would ask every person in the street what he would do with Boeing, and you know, Boeing is coming down really strong recently, and it's quite weak because of the whole corona situation and everything. And finally, some great news in Boeing. If I would ask 100 people on the street if they had any idea about the market, let's say people who do have an idea about the market, what would they do regarding Boeing moving up today? They would certainly say, I'm going to go long, right? I mean, every reasonable person would say, I will buy Boeing today. That's why Boeing should come down, because the market is not built up for normal people. It is targeted for traders. It is targeted for professionals. And you know, the market does behave normally in exactly the opposite way of your normal understanding. So if you're not a professional trader, you should think Boeing should move higher. If you're a professional trader, you would look for a short. You would definitely look for a short. I promised you Boeing under the lows, and Boeing did come under the lows. I was sure it's going to come under the lows because ordinary people would love to go long Boeing, which would make the institutional sellers sell more. You know, they're only going to use this upside spike to get rid of Boeing, to take some profits back home, whatever. I mean, you look at Boeing and think it's going to move higher, think 180 degrees. That's the way to make money in the market. The way to make money in the market is really thinking the opposite way. The market is really designed in a way that its job is to take the money of the ordinary people and put it in the pockets of the professional traders. I'm not joking. This is the target of the market. This is what the market is targeted for. That's the way the market works. If you're not professional, you think you should go long. If you are a professional, you think you should go short. Because the market is really designed this way, to be in exactly 180 degrees of a normal person's ideas, or whatever you'll call it. So that's really the secret of trading. You go short when everybody else thinks they need to go long. So let's put Boeing beside. Take a look at ZM. Just a nice upside trade. I can't remember who alerted me to ZM today. It had a beautiful breakout formation here, and it just moved over the highs because the market was moving over the highs, still going over the highs. An interesting thing I should say about ZM, hold on a second, I want to put up the S&P here. Look at ZM. It hasn't done anything wrong. It's uptrending. But there were some points where we moved out at 553. There were some points where it pulled back down. Now, if you had too much size, it may have taken you out of this trade. But if you look at the chart of ZM, you need to ask yourself, did it do anything wrong? No, it hasn't done anything wrong. It was just uptrending. I guess some of you guys couldn't hold, couldn't take the hit, and possibly moved out on this, for example, spike. I want to mention this spike because it was right at 10 o'clock. You take a look at here at 10 o'clock. It happened just at 10 o'clock. Now, what happened at the S&P at 10 o'clock? At the same time ZM was moving down, the S&P was moving to a new high. You see, that just happened over 10 o'clock. And if the S&P just moved over the highs at 10 o'clock, you shouldn't be worried about this spike down. In fact, if you may remember in the trading room, I mentioned ZM has done nothing wrong. It's uptrending. The S&P is over the highs. It should respond to the market. And you know, 60% of the movement of the stock has to do with the S&P 500. So if the S&P 500 moves over the highs, it's very, very likely that this was just a normal noise in ZM and it would soon join what the S&P is doing. Does that always work? No, sometimes it doesn't. That's when we have losers. But the reason we go long a stock that has a nice technical formation is because it's likely to continue with the technical formation. And if you have a noise that takes it down a little bit, you normally shouldn't be worried. Of course, you should have your stop somewhere. But if you take a look at the chart, it hasn't done anything wrong. The S&P at that time was over the highs, which means that ZM is very, very likely to go with it. And finally, it did. So that's a beautiful uptrend in ZM. Of course, my biggest winner for the day, over $6,000, and I'm still hoping, over 6 points right now. So ZM's trending higher. Same idea was with BABA. We went long when it has a nice technical formation. Also, not my pick. You guys picked it today. I just joined. I just posted it in the trading room saying I think it should be a reasonable, you know, it was looking nice. It just moved. It was about to move over the highs and we traded BABA. It was beautiful. The only loser I have is shorting JBHT. Now we take a look at JBHT and you may ask yourself, why do I have a loser if I was right? I was definitely right. But it's also about timing. The same thing with Boeing. My timing for the first trade was not right. Timing for the second one was perfect. Timing for my first trade in JBHT was all wrong. Look at it. Tried to go short here. It looked like it's about to break down on the lows, but then it took over the highs. I gotta have a stop loss somewhere. Took the second one. It went sideways for too long. You're not supposed to stay in a stock that is not going your way. And I moved out. It was the right thing to do. I have to say, although I'm looking at it right now and I'm very, very sorry I couldn't hold, it was the right thing to go. The stock was up and down like a roller coaster here at the lows and finally did manage to come down. So yeah, I was not wrong about the market, about the stock's direction. It was a nice gap and go as it should be, but it just happened too long. And again, trading is sometimes just about having the right time. So it's not just picking the right stock, it's about having the timing as well. So you know what? All in all, 1, 2, 3, 4 green trade. Didn't even mention SRNE, although it was a nice gap and go. And just one loser in JBHT. 4 green days. One red day for the week. I'm happy. I'm going to the weekend very, very happy, and had a very nice trading week and trading day. And I really want to thank you all for joining with our trading room. Thank you guys for joining. You guys in YouTube too. Please give us a thumb up. That will help us. And thank you all, and have a really great weekend. And I hope to see all of you here early next week. And keep safe, of course, with all this coronavirus going on crazy around the world. Thank you for joining again. See you next week. Bye, traders. Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, we invite you to join the TradeNet Trading Room for a free 14-day trial. TradeNet has educated more than 30,000 professional traders worldwide since 2004, and its trading room is one of the world's leading trading communities. Click here to start your free trial. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.